When baby balloon was exposed to hot water, she expanded, while when mommy balloon was exposed to cold water, she became smaller. This phenomenon is explained through the Chow's law, where volume and temperature is directly proportional. When the temperature is high, then the volume is also high and vice versa.
In the problem, the initial volume is 30 liters. The initial temperature is 1.00 times 10 raised to 3 degrees Celsius, and the final temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. The question is, what is the final volume of carbon dioxide? We can apply Charles' law to solve this problem. According to his law, the ratio of the initial volume and the initial temperature is equal to the ratio of the final volume and the final temperature. So our equation will be V1 over T1 equals V2 over T2. First, we convert the temperature in degrees Kelvin by adding 273. So the initial temperature is 1273 Kelvin and the final temperature is 298 Kelvin. We can solve the final volume by multiplying T2 in both sides so that the remaining value is V2. Substituting the values in the equation and calculating, the final volume is 7 liters as the final answer with 1 as the least significant figure. In the problem, the initial volume is 600.0 milliliters, the initial temperature is 77.0 degrees Celsius, and the final temperature is 86.0 degrees Celsius. The question is, what is the final volume of nitrogen? First, we convert the volume in liters by dividing 1000. So the initial volume is 0.6 liter. We can solve the final volume by multiplying T2 in both sides so that the remaining value is V2. Substituting the values in the equation and calculating, the final volume is 0.615 liter.